Welcome to the Great Exodus series, God's plan of rescue for His children. Let my people go, the path to Mount Zion. And today's topic is about be a Christian only. What do I mean by that? Many people believe that to be a Christian, it is very, very difficult. And they're fighting so much and say, oh, I'm in a miserable situation and the enemy is fighting me all the time and he's coming against me and it's so difficult to be a Christian in this world. But the problem is, the true problem is that they try to serve two masters. That's the reason why their yoke is so difficult. Because they try to remain in the world. Serve the worldly master Satan and his minions to have their jobs and their careers and their riches and their wealth and their cars and their properties. And in this way, serving the enemy. And at the same time, they want to be a good Christian. And so they are in between the two forces and they are torn apart. And so it becomes very difficult for them to be a true Christian. But has not Jesus said, my yoke is light? Has he not said, I'm not giving you a strong burden, big burden? No. He said, my yoke is light. And because of that, you have to understand that if you are in a problem phase right now, and if you are torn apart, then that you are doing something wrong. Be a true Christian only. That means you have to come out of the world and out of Babylon. Forget about your money, forget about your resources, forget about your companies, your jobs, your careers. Even your family, if necessary, and turn to the Lord, turn to the righteous path, turn to the heavenly kingdom. And then if you do that, and you are not anymore serving two masters, the world and heaven, what is impossible to serve, then, and only then, you will walk the narrow path. Only then you will be a true Christian, not only by name, but also by deeds and action. So stop serving two masters. Because if you serve two masters, the enemy has a stronghold on you. You are still trying to fight, you are still bickering, you are backstabbing, you are calling names. All this is a sign that you are still in the enemy camp, at least with one leg. You have to come out of this. You have to repent and ask the Holy Spirit to guide you. Come out of the world and out of Babylon. Forget about your luxuries. Forget about your careers. Some people are telling me, instead to call you forth to share resources, I should work. How do you know that I'm not working? I'm working for the Lord. I have a full-time ministry. But I'm not working for the enemy. And I'm not willing to go back into the world and to serve him. Because I'm serving the Father only. And Jesus Christ, his only begotten Son. So don't come with your words and say that I should go and look for a job. I am outside of the world and outside of Babylon. And if you do not want to walk with us together, that's your choice. Then you will remain in the world and you have to face Antichrist. That's your choice. But don't come with your words and your talks and your backstabbing and your fighting and your name calling. This has no place in our ministry. And no comment of this will ever reach our websites or any of our videos. It will all be deleted. Because here we are true Christians, not only by name, but also by action and deeds. And we are operating outside of the world and outside of Babylon, on the path to Mount Zion. So you can join us, or you can say whatever you want to say about us, but then you will not be part of us anymore. It's your choice. Many, many people are now in a valley of decision. The bride's physical removal will be very, very soon after the spiritual escape has taken place in July, on the 17th of July, when heaven opened and the names were put down for the physical escape that will take place until the 24th of September this year. Now the first seal, the White Rider, will open in August. The first start, the first manifestation of good and evil will take place this month. But you have to decide where you want to stand. Either remain in the world and you will stay with the evil side, or you come out of the world and you will stay on the heavenly kingdom side. Choose life over death. Return. Repent of your worldly ways. Repent and come back to the Lord. This is a call to return to the Lord. Come back. Can you still think about funds, about money, about resources, about your careers, about your worldly standing, about worldly honors, about gold and riches? Then you have not made a decision to come out of the world. You are still fixed inside there. The enemy has still a very strong grip on you. But I am calling you out of the world and out of Babylon. Use your resources to advance the kingdom and not to buy another Rolls Royce or play another game that you bought for a lot of money, where you spent all your time with, instead to advance the heavenly kingdom. Come out of the world, out of your dependency on the enemy side, and walk with us the path to Mount Zion. Spiritual escape of the bride in July has taken place. Many people had outer body experience and went to heaven and saw the place that they were going to very soon, physically. The bride will be removed. And then the great exodus will start. You have to prepare. You have to pack your bags. You have to say goodbye to the world and to Babylon. Because when the time has come that we move out, then we will move out. With you or without you. Your time has come to make a decision. To be ready. Walk with us that narrow and middle path towards Mount Zion, where we will be raptured into paradise and be with the Father, Yahweh, and His only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, forever and ever. If you need more understanding about Mount Zion and about the timeline and the time frames and what will happen now and what will happen in 1 month and in 2 months, I recommend to you to go to the YouTube channel Ministry Revealed. He has a great channel with great information about the true timeline that is happening. But please understand that the heavenly kingdom is a spiritual kingdom first, before a manifestation takes place in the physical. It is a spiritual understanding. First the spiritual, as the spiritual escape of the bride has taken place in July. And then the physical removal will take place. The same way as in the book of Daniels. The angel had no physical access until they have fought with the angel of Persia. So Michael came to help, and then after 21 days, they could then reach the physical level to talk. But before, the message that was given out through prayer was received in the spiritual 3 weeks before the physical appearance. So you have to understand there is a spiritual side and a physical side. This is very, very important. But as soon as the spiritual side has started, what we have seen in July, then the physical side is not very far off. And the manifestation of all the power and glory of the Father and His only begotten Son Jesus Christ will take place. And the vanishing of the bride will come to pass. Maybe not as you see it, or as you wish it, and maybe even not with you, but it will come to pass. You speak against it, if you use bad language against it, if you call names, or whatever you do, it will not stop the manifestation of the power and glory of the Father. Thank you that you have listened to this important video. And please, be a true Christian and come out of the world and out of Babylon. And do not try to serve two masters. Stay in the world and be a Christian. That will not work. Because you will compromise and you will bring in tolerance, and all what is holy you will burn in the fire of your tolerance. And at the end of the day, you will call good evil and evil good. And that is the worst. So please come out of the world. Money is not important. Resources are not important. They are only there to advance the kingdom, to help within mission, to lift up the needy, to help the Lazarus at the gate, to look for the nameless and faceless. They are not there for your own entertainment and for your riches and for your worldly glory or honor. No. Is there to advance the kingdom. And if you do not have the understanding about money, then you are still trapped within the world and within the enemy and the beast system. Please pray over it and ask the Holy Spirit to guide you so that you come out of that spirit of money. You can come out of the spirit of having problem to share something from your side. Having problem to share resources for the heavenly work. If you have a problem with that, then you see how the enemy is still holding you hostage. So please come out. Read the book of Acts, where everybody is selling their access to do what? To lay it at the feet of the apostles. To do what? To allow them their missions and to lift up the needy. And did they have any problems? No. Because they were all of one mind and one spirit. They came together to support one another and to lift up the needy. And everybody received as he had need. If a need is there, then it will be met. With you or without you. Because God is never leaving his children alone. Thank you for your understanding. Thank you for your help in our mission to Cambodia. Thank you that you assist us with your resources so that we can reach more people. Not to make us rich, we don't care about the money. We only use the funds to reach more people so that we can gather them together at Mount Zion, so that the harvest is great as it is written in the book of Revelation. You can be part of it. If you cannot walk with us physically there, you can help us with your donations. So please understand that everything what you give is for the advancement of the kingdom. I love you all so dearly, and I hope that you have understood the message today. And please, if you are belonging to Satan, come out of the world and out of Babylon. And I hope that the Lord will bless you today. My name is Michael. I'm the founder of Triple Grace and the Righteous Path Movement Foundation. And I will see you again tomorrow for the next topic. Have a blessed day. Maranatha.